will discuss again. I'm just giving you examples. See, when you see the theory part and when you see the question paper part, they are not in the same paradigm. They are in different paradigms. So you need to write the best answer possible to impress the examiner. That is the ultimate goal. For example, we will think about it. We don't know anything about attitude, or we know what is there in the theory part. How will you approach this answer? How could social influence and persuasion contribute to the success of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan? Now, remember your past learnings, values, family, education, society, moral exemplars. You remember all those things, right? Can you bring all those things and think in this particular answer? Just do a brainstorming thing. We will learn the theory part. Theory is very easy. It's hardly 30 minutes. What we need is, how are we seeing things? Once your paradigm shift happens or your perception changes, attitude chapter becomes very easy. And why you need to pick up examples from newspapers is even more evident in such practices. You can apply the ABC model if you need to. Affective, cognitive and behavioral models. You can try ABC model or you can try examples. You only, not getting? Thinking. If you understand the perspective, trust me, in the exam hall you will be very very happy that you have done this exercise, or else just mere reading without application of ethics is going to come back and haunt you. 2020 paper is the difficult paper in my opinion. You can ask anyone who wrote mains, they were literally crying. They gave up half of the paper, they couldn't complete the paper because it's not easy for you to think in the exam hall with contemporary examples. Yes, done. This is Shwini. could recollect whatever you can about Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. How you can persuade or contribute to the success of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan? Any examples? Did you think of any examples? Okay. Like, how do you achieve that?
First thing is, he made cleanliness an important value. We tried making it a part of our
lives. Okay.
And that was the first nudge to implement Swachh Bharat Abhiyan across India. And the second thing is, we've used model examples. Like, Gandhi was the face of
Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. The Panchayat Raj institution, the funding mechanism. So we were cognitively affecting their.
Our social system. Also tells
we
were people who
gave products
to them. So that is
the cognitive approach.
Okay. Any examples, anyone?
So it is a success story of our district in Chhattisgarh. And the character was very much influential in implementing Swachh Bharat. It came up to be the most clean district in the state. And it was implemented for other districts also.
E-village, smart villages, we have RFID waste management collection. Okay, fine. But again, how could social influence and persuasion? That is the T terms, right? Social influence and persuasion. Social and influence. ROAs, right? But the thing is, people don't go by facts, right? I don't care. Normally speaking, an average citizen will never understand. For example, if you invest in $1 of anti-smoking campaigns, it will save $80 or something like that. Health wise, it's a huge amount of save. But that is not something we can actually use to persuade, right? Like, if have you ever seen a hoarding saying this? Now again, I totally understand that, but whenever you use data, facts don't change people's mind. If I say, if you work for 12 hours a day, you'll become an IAS, okay? That fact doesn't change your mind. I have to tell you a story. Yes, social persuasion is all about stories, right? See, again, I totally understand with you. On a personal level, if this was GS paper 2, I will definitely write that point. Why? From a policymaker point of view, I am considering return of income. Yes, $1 invested in Swachh Bharat saves malnourishment, stunting, child wasting, maternal mortality rate. But in ethics, when I say how could social influence and persuasion, you have to be creative and you have to pick up examples from your own city. For example, Hyderabad has removed all the trash cans. Recently, have you noticed? The dustbins, the steel bins which used to be like the big ones, they are removed throughout the city. And they are collecting the waste. Why? ABC model. If you see the cognitive thing, trash attracts trash. That means the moment I see a corner with a lot of trash, I will also throw my cover. But if I don't see a trash and I see a clean garden, like throughout the city, I will take it all the way till some area to throw the dust, right? So that is persuasion through mechanisms. Okay, I understand. I hope you understand, right? See, you have to make the city cleaner, then people will be shied away to throw the waste, or others will look down at you. For example, in apartments, you don't throw covers from your balcony, right? Those days are gone. Earlier, people used to do all these things. For example, there was a lady in some state, I don't remember which state. She refused to go to the in-laws' house because there is no toilet. She has become an example for the entire state to replicate. So people stopped getting married, people started constructing to get the bride's home. Social influence and persuasion. Yes, Param Iyer.
During the first part of the
I will come. I am not totally sure. I haven't read it. So again, if you take Param Iyer, Parameswaran Iyer, he's the one who headed the Swachh Bharat campaign, right? He got into a twin latrine pit and he cleaned the pit, right? So Iyer, an upper caste fellow and an IAS officer, getting into a pit and cleaning it is a method of social influence that will influence the subordinate officers, may not directly impact the citizenry, but at least people's behavior will change, right? So what am I doing here? If you take the ABC model, like affective, cognitive and behavioral patterns. Affective is emotions, cognitive is what I see, behavioral is my actions in response to my past beliefs or anything. For example, I am having a negative emotion towards, you know, the waste, either solid waste or human waste or all these things. So I have a repulsion towards waste. Okay, so that is my attitude towards it. The moment I see it, it's a repulsive thing. Yes, then I'm not even interested to look into that direction. Then I won't change my belief systems. Right. So what do we need to do? We need, this is the outcome of this. Right. So what do I need to do? I need to make it better. For example, I can introduce dustbins, waste covers. Yes, so maybe people won't be bothered to carry that black bag or black cover, but they will be very insulted to carry a trash bin. So if you change the cognitive things also, it will have a lot of impact. But we are talking about Swachh Bharat Abhiyan at all India level. So I'm just giving you basic examples. So at all India level, what do we need to do? We need to create that competitive spirit. Yes, Swachh Bharat Index can also be a persuasion tool. Yes, sorry. Tide funds, Tide funds is GS2 more or less, okay, but the thing is you can apply the Tide funds in a different fashion. For example, the members of panchayatis, okay, they can have a healthy competition. You can change the words, right? You can change the words to tell if the cognitives or affective thought process of the panchayati members is changed, okay, probably the implementation will be better. Yes, see, we have seen people having constructed the toilets. That is the cognitive thing. But this did not change. They did not still use toilets. Yes, so what do I need to do? How can I make a man go to a particular location unless he himself is understanding why he should go? That is where the social persuasion comes into the picture, right? Early morning, all the villagers or the panchayati members come together and stop people for going into open defecation. They need to talk to them. Yes, create programs like, this is what happens. I have to educate him. If you do this, right, open defecation, it will have a lot of diseases, right? That will affect. So I'm changing his behavior through social persuasion. If nobody is going, if everybody is smiling at him or laughing at him, people won't do that. Yes, so it is not easy. Yes.
Started, then
the
police, traffic police, or
the
police started to give flowers to whoever going for the open defecation.
Okay, public urination and all those things, people are given, okay, flower. It is a method to insult them, but at the same time change their behavior. For example, yes, I hope you understand. Now, when you read Yojana or any other standard magazine, right, that is where you are supposed to see the example. So when you see the example, you understand the logic behind it. Yes, if Prime Minister Modi is coming himself on the road and sweeping the roads, so that's a huge social influence. For example, he washed the feet of Safai Karamcharis in Kumbh Mela or something, right? So that is a strong message that is being to send, that, you know, people who serve the society or serve the country are heroes. So a Prime Minister level candidate cleaning the feet is a very strong persuasion tool. At least the next generation of Indians won't think about dignity of labor. When you write this kind of answer, okay, it persuades the examiner also to give you more marks. That's emotional intelligence, right? Because you are not forgetting that you are in GS paper 4. You don't have to write ABC theory, draw diagrams, use technical jargon, attitude is this, that nobody is bothered about all these things. But the thing is, I need to know, you know, what is attitude and how you are smartly using that to tell a story. So ethics is a story of values. That is what I told you in the day one, right? If you remove that value, you are doing this mechanically. You are writing it for the sake of answer writing. Then you are not going to get the marks. But if you add value, why am I doing this? I need my country to be clean, healthy and prosperous. Automatically, your answers will be more impactful. So like all the examples I told you, did they make an impact? I hope you understand, right? Can you think of any other examples? You need to keep looking into the newspapers. Yes? So if you write 5 points like this, Paramayyar did this, Prime Minister Modi washed the feet, okay, he cleaned the streets, yes, the marriage examples, social persuasion, our panchayat is coming together to declare open defecation free, yes, and the persuasion techniques by, then you can add the grants or, awards, persuasion, yes. Can you think of any other examples? See, you don't know that today, but you started a thought process, right? From now on, when you see something in the newspaper, you look at the attitude also of the public servant. Yes? Say, for example, now, as she has mentioned, if I go to a school, if I'm a district collector, what will I teach? I will teach the young generation to hold the wrappers in their pocket and throw them only in the dustbin, right? So that is also one form of social influence. So the powerful you are, the celebrity you are, like the more impact you have, social media influencer or anything, politician, you have good amount of social influence, and that has to be thought. Yes. Now, if I replace the word Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and frame the question in a different format, okay, love jihad. Can you see ABC in love jihad, or how attitudes are being shaped in love jihad? It won't be asked as a question, don't worry about it, but many states are passing the bill love jihad. So how does it affect the social fabric? How is it influencing the social fabric of the society? What do you see in the think about love jihad and the ABC model, because we will link it to communalism, we will link it to so many other things, but you need to see that, right? How ABC are there in love jihad? What is love jihad doing to the ABC of the society?
That is because of A, right? You have a feeling that.
But converting into a bill will also have B and C. Can you see that? How? For example, there is this viral video in YouTube nowadays. Rasputin, two Kerala medical students, medicos danced for 30 seconds or something on Rasputin. Yes? So a comment in their YouTube feed or Facebook feed was this. Okay, be careful of the conversion. So some person commented to the parents of that particular doctor, female doctor in that video, that be careful of your daughter, right? So now there is a whole campaign going in Kerala against, you know, hatred, that songs are for love, not to promote love jihad or something like that. So why is society discussing all these things? So how does the love jihad concept fit into the attitude chapter? So if you have to link love jihad and attitude, can we see? And I will also ask you to read one more article by Rajiv Bhargava. I don't know whether you remember it. Rajiv Bhargava used to write articles about secularism, religious freedom and all those things. The other, right? The other. So there is always an other. So we don't know the other. So how is ABC coming into the picture in relation to the other? For example, we can also do the same thing to refugees. Yes, Rohingyas, or CAA bill, or NRC bill, right? So again, coming back to the love jihad thing, as you rightly pointed out, I have a feeling or negative feeling towards the other. Yes or no? So I don't know them. I have no clue what they are. Somebody told me a story. I don't like them. So that is A component. Okay. But if someone like me, if you meet someone like me, I will try to persuade you that is not the true case. As you have rightly pointed out, I will show them empirical data. Out of the 14 cases inquired, only 12 cases are innocent. Only 2 cases are that too subjective. Right? If I use my pet name, instead of my real name, that is not some crime, right? So then I will try to persuade you. That is when you try to find some examples. So that is where the fake news and the other things come into the picture, right? All I need is one example of a cognitive thing to put a drop in the ocean. So there is an ocean of water and all I need is one drop of chemical. So I will rally entirely around this one particular cognitive thing to affect these two things. So if you hate me, I gave you one drop of hate proof to hate me more. And you will be happily buying that. You will rationalize, right? Yes or no? So when I changed a bill or when I made it into a bill, what is happening? It is creating a behavioral actions and intentions. You are afraid even to bring it into action. So if these three circles are moving away from each other, I will live in a bubble and I'm happy. And that kind of bills are creating that kind of environment. The opposite is also true. We should not persuade that there is no such thing as a conspiracy. Let's say there is a conspiracy. I also need to work on that rationally. That is also when attitude helps me. So I have a skeptical mind. I am not convinced that there is something called as love jihad. Okay, then what should I do? I should change my behavioral component for inquiry, knowledge. I need more data. Conduct an inquiry throughout the country. If there are 500 cases in India, right, where this actually has happened, then the cognitive ability changed my behavior. Like it flows into each other, right? Knowledge changes into cognitive, cognitive changes into knowledge. What happened because of that? My skeptical mind or my thought process has changed and I accepted, yes, there is a theory. So I can use it in two ways. So that is how you see the things in the newspaper. So when we don't see them, what will we do? We stay most of the time in affective thing. That means I am emotional. Somebody said something and I am angry. I don't do this. And trust me, it's a very, very painful thing to do these two things. To sit and look at data which I don't like or which I don't want to hear is the most painful thing a human being can do. That is why attitudes are strong, deep. And attitudes are consistent. Yes or no? Are we clear? The refugees. I have a cognitive thing. Somebody with social influence. For example, let's say a minister in a cabinet mentioned that, you know, they are terrorists. I have one piece of cognitive information that will influence these two things. Right? So if I'm already this and this, then it's easy for me to this. You can see the same in communalism, fault lines. Now, what is the opposite of all these things? How do we do, how do we change everything? Like for example, if I'm going in, attitudes can create be positive and negative, right? So positive attitudes can also be created. Yes? For example, let's say about the movie ads, smoking and all those things. In the starting of the movie, there is this Rahul Dravid ad, earlier Mukesh. Why? So that this will happen. Yes? So as long as you don't see Mukesh picture or some, you know, jaw that has been removed, which is very ugly to watch at. Okay? That is why there is this tobacco packing. Yes or no? And in Australia, we have come to a proof that if I remove or white label the tobacco products, if the cigarette packets are very plain, no attraction whatsoever, youth will be dissuaded from using this. Yes? For example, if you stop selling cigarettes in a loose packets, I am affecting this component. For example, if I go to a pawn shop and I say one cigarette, individually I am buying it, I'm smoking it, I'm going back to my home. But if I change the behavior, for example, if I make it frictional, if I add layers, what do? I say, you cannot sell individual cigarettes. So not every person can buy a pack and keep it, right? He will be caught. Students cannot do that. Yes, one day they might survive, 2 days they might survive, but that pressure or fear will be there. So I'm affecting their behavioral component. So it will change their this. It will affect their emotions. Family might find out. A lot of problems can be created. And I'm changing his belief system. It's better to give up smoking than get caught every day and have this torture every day. Yes or no? The same thing can be applied for alcohol, right? Sell only full bottles, not in quarters and halves. Okay, then what will happen? You cannot stand outside the wine shop and pour it into a glass and drink then and there, right? Either you have to buy the full bottle, which probably you don't have the money for, right? Not at least on an everyday basis. So then I am creating frictions. So this is what tech companies do. They target this. They make it as frictionless as possible. Skip intro. Next episode playing. Why does Netflix give you all these options? Or YouTube give you all these options? It is making your life as frictionless as possible. So the less the friction, the more your pleasure-seeking behavior, that will become your habit. Yes or no? Say lazy people, right? We are all lazy people. If I have to change, take the remote, play next, I may not watch the next episode. But if I don't do that, automatically binge watch. It keeps on going till I sleep. And now TVs are getting so smart. My smartwatch will detect me and I slept and it will stop. So life is frictionless. Yes or no? So say they actually play on your attitude, right? That is all your behavioral component. These are the things you don't see in the books, but they see you see them in the real life. Yes? Now, opposite is also true. Once you know that your attitudes are being manipulated like this, what can you do? You can always add frictions. Yes, so there is a new book called as Make Time. Make Time is a book written by two software engineers. They work out for YouTube, how to make YouTube more popular. So now they wrote a book, how not to make YouTube popular. I mean, in the sense, how to make your time more effective. Add frictions. For example, log out of all your social media accounts. Keep a lengthy password. Next time when you have to log in, you have to type that lengthy password. So in the 2 minutes, you'll be either irritated or you'll stop that hunch to watch that YouTube video. Yes or no? See, now thanks to mobile phones, we don't have to log into anything, right? Almost all the time, things are accessible. So that is why very easy for us to keep watching. But if you type a 20-letter password for Netflix, okay, which you don't even remember, you have to open a book or something. Yes? I hope you understand. Or you can have this two-factor authentication. 20-letter password, then two-factor authentication, then OTP. So it like 3 minutes to just log into the Netflix, then you will lose all the interest in the world to watch Netflix. So that is also one. See, what I'm trying to tell you is, when I know how my attitude is formed, I can also use it for my betterment or my destruction. When I know how communalism is being created using fake news to change the behavioral component of the people, okay, I can use it to reverse that also. I can use the same tools to create a different narration. Yes, see, all you need to do is what? Be the best in what you do. For example, if A.R. Rahman is there, A.R. Rahman created very beautiful songs. Whenever you are depressed, whenever you are feeling patriotic, you listen to that Roja song or some other Vande Mataram, automatically your patriotism will increase. Right? So there are other ways to change your cognitive and behavioral components. Clear? So from today onwards, whenever you see something in the newspaper, you need to remember how these things are coming into the picture. Now, West Bengal elections. West Bengal elections is probably one of the most communalized elections in recent times. It has led to a lot of deaths. Okay. So why did, when the elections in happening, elections are happening in Hyderabad, they chose the term Bhagyanagar? Right? It literally controls these two things. See, I'm emotively linked to the term Hyderabad. Okay. And I'm also thinking that it's a religious term. To the religious term, you relate it to emotive term. Okay, so I have to steer your emotions. Emotions are the biggest asset for any company, politician, party, anyone, right? Even your family members, your dad, when he tries to persuade you, he tries to affect this, right? Not these two things. So emotions are our weak areas. So the term Bhagyanagar, it has created a emotive thing. Then cognitive. Going to that particular temple under the Charminar, Bhagyanagar temple. Yes, so what is that doing? Emotive and a symbol, a symbolism. When we create symbols, we attach to that symbols. So when I associate with myself with a particular color or anything, it gives me an identity. So attitude shapes my identity, right? So my self-esteem is what? By being associated to something. Yes or no? All these things are there in your theory part, but I'm showing you the real life examples. See, on an individual level, I don't have an identity. But the moment I associate, I am from IIT, I am Ahmedabad. Okay, that increases my self-esteem. Yes? So, cognitive beliefs. Clear? So, think about all the examples you can think of. For example, the farmers' bill agitation, the farmers' agitation. What happened in the farmers' agitation? In the initial days, it was an emotive issue, right? People don't have a clue. People don't have knowledge. They were not sure whether the farmers were right or the government was right. Okay. Then what happened? Feelings were hurt. Red fort, Indian flag was insulted. Overnight, what happened? The moral support for the farmers' bill has come down very, very drastically. Yes? So this led to this. So all the three things are very fluid. For understanding sake, we actually use the diagrams, but in reality they are like one single circle, three single circles overlapping with each other like this. It's a very colorful picture, but the thing is, it's very, very hard to understand which will lead to what, which will lead to this. Yes or no? So take any example, anything you see in the newspaper will have an attitudinal factor. For example, attitude of an individual, attitude of a civil servant are two different things. Yes or no? If you, I think I have shared this Gaurav Agarwal post. Gaurav Agarwal is an IAS, All India topper. He worked in Gujarat, right? So during COVID times, he was working in Gujarat. I shared that link. So he wrote his entire experiences, right? So if he is personally having a negative attitude towards certain communities or certain diseases, okay, he couldn't have done what he has done. Yes or no? Why? As mentioned in the particular book I have recommended, see, he talks about how an IAS officer will face a lot of things, right? From subordinates, superiors, problems, unexpected problems, daily issues. When you are so frustrated, you have so many things to deal with, right? You cannot show the anger of one person to another issue. So you need to maintain that attitude, like how to deal with what. And only when your attitude is deeply enshrined, that comes naturally. If some old woman comes to you for pension, among all the headaches in your life, personal, professional, and all those things, your attitude is what? Helping her. Your first thought is to help her no matter what. That is deeply ingrained in you. That comes from value system. Then automatically we'll do the right thing. For example, see this question. Our attitude towards this we can understand because the other day we have discussed family, society and educational values. So attitude is a what? Manifestation of your values. See, only when you have a value system, you like it or dislike it, right? So some of these unconsciously acquired attitudes and values are often undesirable. It's a very beautiful question, right? Citizen of modern democratic and egalitarian society. So please remember, when you see keywords in the paper like modern democratic, so the modern values apply, your preamble applies, justice, equality, fraternity, and egalitarian society, there are no hierarchies, right? So I'm here, they are here, these things don't apply. Discuss such undesirable values prevalent in today's this is not something you read and go. Yes or no? This is something you observe from today and go to the exam hall to write. People do the opposite. Sir, I read DK Balaji for 3 times. It is not going to fetch you marks no matter what. To show me that line in the DK Balaji or any standard textbook. Right? So, today's educated Indians. Why educated Indians? They are the elites. Elites shape the society, right? How such undesirable attitudes can be changed? And socio-ethical values, public services be cultivated in aspiring civil servants. He is asking about you only. So, how such attitudes can be changed and socio-ethical values considered necessary in public services? First of all, we need to identify what are the socio-ethical values needed for public services cultivated in the aspiring things. So, he is asking you about cognitive changes. Yes or no? How can I persuade you? How can I change your attitudes while you are preparing itself so that they will be deeply ingrained? Now, the problem is this question cannot be written just like that. You need to have deep understanding of the Indian society and your surroundings. When you see your surroundings, only then you will change. Can anyone tell me the point one?
Individualism
is a negative undesirable society. I can be individualistic, but at the same time I can be philanthropic. So, not selfishness, right? I like what is individualism in your thought process? Okay, fine. Self-centered individualism. Fine. Okay, then that is true, right? Everybody will think of their own sake. They are least bothered about others. Apathy. Apathy in relation to what?
Politics.
Apathy in relation to politics. I will share you a comic. Do remind me. I will share you an Instagram clip. Yes. Adding value to your thought process. Like, why apathy is a political attitude. It's a very good comic strip.
Materialism.
But again, remember, the question clearly says, your orientation has to be in that angle also. Social hierarchies. Casteism. Yes, materialistic values also will hamper the democratic or egalitarian society in the longer run, because if I am acquiring all the possessions, or if I try to keep everything for me, my community, or power sharing agreements are not there, that will definitely hamper the egalitarian society. For example, if you take Uttar Pradesh in India or Reddy community in Andhra Pradesh itself, they have a lot of bargaining power. I'm not saying they are anti-democratic or not creating egalitarian society, but there is some biasness or some tilt towards the power centers, right? And that is not here. Yes, educated Indians. So when you listen to your society classes, or when you see your newspapers, daily newspapers, or anything that is happening in the society, for example, can you link it to vaccination? Can you link it to the COVID times? Think from any contemporary times. You may or may not find immediate examples, but if you have the thought process in the mind that I need to keep looking things from a whole new perspective, you also throw in that. So when you read newspaper articles, that is what we do. We apply to 1, 2, 3, and 4 papers. Yes. Say, for example, there was an article in the newspaper the other day. Some doctors in India wrote a letter to Prime Minister of India saying that there are VVIP counters in many government hospitals, only to cater to MLAs and MPs. Yes or no? And we don't find it objectionable. Yes. No? See, that is where moral persuasion come into the picture. The Prime Minister himself went to, like when he went to Kerala, he took the first dose. Now he went to AIIMS. So he could have called some doctor to his own home. He could have used his privilege. But as any other citizen, 60 plus, he went to a government hospital to get the vaccination. That is social persuasion, that nobody is above any thing. So he is giving an example for egalitarian society. I'm just giving you, that is not the answer. I'm telling you, when you see the newspapers, see them. Right? See, if I give you ready-made example, Mokshagundam Vishweshwaraya again, okay, examiner will be bored to death. Yes or no? But when you write these examples from everyday life, when you see them, that is your perspective and nobody can take it away. Probably in 10,000 answer sheets, hardly 1,000 people will write the similar examples. That is good enough for you to get an interview call. Clear? Yes. See, I didn't want you to bore to death with the typical attitude class, like what is attitude, what is ABC model, behavioral. You need to see that. Once your perception changes towards how to see newspapers or how to pick up examples, things will change. This. The third question. You can pick tons and tons of examples from the recent Bengal elections. Yes or no? From drama all the way till murders. Okay. So here, how can we link it to religion?
So they don't go together.
He cannot have politics without ethics, right? They are not two extremes, right? I can be ethical and political. I can be political and ethical, right? So it is often said that politics and ethics do not go together. Why is one question? And again, it's not political science. No, we have to remember it's about ethics. What is your opinion in this regard? Yes, justify your answers with illustration. So I don't see how Gandhi, that particular quote fits into this answer. First of all, why do they both don't go together? The common perception is this. If I'm very ethical and the other person is manipulating, giving money to the voters, right? Using communal tones and all these things, votes will be going to them. For example, if you take BJP and Mamata Banerjee, hypothetically, not literally. So, or Arvind Kejriwal, for example, he used soft Hindutva. Right? There is this version of, what is that budget? The Delhi budget, what is it called? Janagan Mahasos. Deshbhakti budget or something like that. Okay, so I will tell you, Arvind Kejriwal's recent budget is called as some variety budget. Okay, the thing is, first of all, if I am political, the perception is I am unethical, I am corrupt, I am a criminal, and those who are ethical will never win the elections. That is also a perception. But political parties can both be political and ethical at the same time. If I know I am promoting communalism for the votes, I am not being ethical, because that ethical value is against the democratic constitutional morality. Right? If I am promoting communalism for the sake of votes, after winning the elections, I have to again cool down the communal flares or the state will never grow. Yes? So knowing that, I cannot be ethical. But if I be only ethical, then probably I will not survive or become a party in power. Then how do I balance that? So is it true that they cannot survive with each other? Aren't there enough political parties which can do both? Any examples? Again, yes, justify your answers with illustrations. See, again, Lok Satta is only known to Kukatpally constituency in Hyderabad, right? It doesn't have an all India presence. Yes or no? Bharatiya Janata Party had 2 MPs in 1980s. Okay, after Advani's Radha Yatra, it went to 180. You have to understand, right? These are facts. Again, how is it actually communal, or he is appealing to the emotions of the people? You have to think them also, right? No, it's a very, very controversial question, right? If you answer, you are in a trap. If you don't answer, you will lose marks. So how do you balance that? Politics and ethics don't go together. Then you go to some foreign country. You avoid India altogether. You are not evoking emotions. Yes. For example, Donald Trump has created a lot of drama, fake news. So he was being totally unethical. That is why Joe Biden has won. So ethical people will win. No need to discuss India whatsoever. That is attitude, that is common sense, right? I answered the answer without answering it. Putin. For example, Putin has extended the constitution to promote his own presidential powers. Okay, he is being unethical. So there are examples for unethical. There are examples like Joe Biden, who was a staunch believer, a religious believer. He was ethical. He has won the elections. I am safe. Politics and ethics can go together, right? Definitely, I cannot say politics and ethics cannot go together. Politician should have more virtues than the most of us, because he's a leader. If you remember the determinants of ethics, leadership is one of the component. I hope you remember, right? Yes, plus, minus, plus. So society is there, people are there, people become leader. If a leader is ethical, the moral values will spill over into the society. Modi is uncorruptible. He is not someone known for corruption. Nobody in India with right mind can say Modi is corrupt. He didn't take a single rupee. So that is it. Benchmark he is setting for the next generation of younger Indians. So I have to be genuine like him. I have to do social service without taking into or involving into corruption. So that leads to good citizens. Good citizens lead to good societies. That is a cycle. So ethics are very important for politics rather than any other institution. Yes or no? You have honest bureaucracy, you have honest citizenry, but corrupt leadership, that is the end of societies. So if you ask me, he should have more empathy, sympathy, compassion, everything that we ought to have in a person. Clear? Yes, then I will throw examples, illustrations. So whenever you face some conundrum, please go to foreign countries. Okay, because the moment you write BJP, Congress or anything, you don't know who is evaluating and what his political affiliations is. I'm not saying they are biased. I'm not, ridiculing UPSC's evaluation process. I'm telling you why even give that scope. So out of 10, you get 5, you are safe. 6 is better, but you should not fall to 3. So that's a stand. Clear? See, all the questions are in the similar fashion. Some things you have to see in the newspaper. This. We are witnessing increase in sexual violence against women in the country. Despite existing legal provisions, the number of such incidents are on the rise. Suggest some innovative measures to tackle the menace. So this is again about social persuasion, moral persuasion, cognitive abilities, attitudinal change of the society, right? Yes. See, we can say, for example, the movies like Thappad, Pink, or Vakil Saab, all these things are increasing nowadays, bringing in more awareness to the society. This was not happening few years ago. Clear? So, I hope you will remember all these things and start seeing things. So again, the question paper is available everywhere, right? But you need to spend some time on thinking on the society. See, again, observe the targeted questions. Women, caste, educated Indians, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So attitude is more focused towards a bureaucratic approach or your thought process towards society. Yes, how you are going to influence the society, because attitude plays a bigger role in society, because civil servants have values. Values automatically are to be your attitude. For example, honesty, integrity, transparency, empathy, compassion, they are your attitude, right? When you are bound to have all of them, that is what makes you a good civil servant.
Sir, if all these questions
that is when I told you, right? You have to pick up the examples which appear like you are writing an ethical answer. See, again, why do you assume that our society is different from ethical? Our society is ethical society. So when you write ethical society examples, you are automatically writing an ethical answer, right? It's all about, you know, fine tuning, using that right word in the right momentum, and everything will change. For example, if I have to write this article in GS paper 1, I will write about Sexual Harassment Act in depth, because I will throw some lines there. It doesn't matter. In 1, 2, 3 papers, if this question comes, I will use the act, you will use the data, NCRB data. But when the same question is asked in ethics, I will focus more on the terms like dharma, niti, yatra naryasu pujyante, I will throw that quote. So I will make it look like an ethical answer, because nobody knows an ethical answer, right? There is no benchmark. So when there is no benchmark, anything I write will be accepted, but I have to use the terms. Yes. So I can use terms like, you know, the social persuasion techniques in villages, in towns, the civilization or Indian ethos. I will use the term Indian ethos. We call every other person with some relation names. Yes or no? Mama, Baba, Akka, something we use in villages, and everybody is everybody to someone. So why do we use those terms? To maintain that social discipline and moral discipline. So that Indian ethos will teach me to respect women more. When I use the word Indian ethos, nobody knows what they are, and it is accepted. But I cannot write Sexual Harassment Act as it is. So you get the point, right? Value system. I'm still not manipulating UPSC. I'm still giving value to the value system. What is my value system? Respect women. How do I do it? Innovatively. Clear? We can go to dharma, we can go to Ramayana, we can say Indian epics and religious scriptures, in all religion scriptures, promote the respect for women. Yes. And obviously you can find, if you look deeply into this particular question, we will find some examples. Some IAS or officer or some district must have done something to promote reduce sexual harassment in the country. So ethics paper, one advantage is nobody knows or nobody have exact blueprint, and he cannot argue that this is not the answer. The beauty of ethics is I'm taking a stand, and I'm taking it with rationality and value system. So my value system may not be your value system, right? So for example, I will say sexual violence increases with alcoholism and drugs. So I will also bring in that. If you follow the Gandhian ethics, or if you implement the Gandhian values in the society of an alcoholic state, automatically sexual violence will also come down. When I use the Gandhian value system, nobody can argue against that. Right? That is not the exact point I write in GS paper 1. It's what we call as wordplay, right? We have to use the systems, value system, Gandhi, Indian ethos, dharma. And that is something which is missing in most of the answers. They write mechanically. They directly write mechanically. They answer like step 1, Sexual Harassment Act is there, still violence is NCRB data. It's not a wrong thing, but examiner needs some new high. Yes or no? He needs to see your answer as a cool drink in the summer day. Because he was afraid to death, right? She showed a grass, like, you know. Again, you have to reframe it. You have to reframe it saying, you know, we have to go back to the ethos system where our religious values are deeply enshrined. Innovative solutions. From childhood onwards, if you teach the children family value system, like grandmothers, grandfathers, our family value systems are instead of watching that idiotic rhymes, right? You teach them Indian ethos through animations. Okay, so this entire generation will grow up seeing the belief system. Then they will know how Ravana mistreated Sita and how you are supposed to treat Sita. So you have to just modify whatever you are saying in the right orientation. It should be realistic at the same time. So if I say, if I go to a molester and say, you know, you are acting like Ravana, don't be like Ravana, he won't change. Right? But if I teach it to a small kid from the school level only, probably that value system will be ingrained in him. Clear? Got the point? So again, ethics is not a rocket science. It's all about application. Application is what changes your answers from the rest of the crowd. Trust me, when you write this, everybody will appreciate. There is nothing not to appreciate. If you write a GS paper to answer, it's a subjective. Clear? And please don't do the mistake everybody is doing. Learn daily, practice in the exam hall. Don't go to the exam hall to find out your fault lines. Yes? Any questions? See, again, you can read the standard textbook, right? It's very self-explanatory chapter. Almost all the terms are there. But my intention is the questions you see, the application level needed and what you're reading are not on the same page. You have to modify your thinking. I think you can understand what I try to do today. When you see newspapers from today onwards, keep an eye. Yes? See, you can use it for so many things. For example, you can promote female hygiene, that is a taboo in the society, right? That also can be changed through Swachh Bharat, social influence and persuasion. I think Pune or some city has created a public toilet with a dedicated room for women. Okay, so such small cognitive things will make a huge impact. A lot of things are happening in the society, but as I told you, civil servant point of view is less, society point of view is more. Refugees, you can apply the same thing. Communalism, you can apply the same thing. Yes. Political ideology, why hate is a bad thing, you can apply. Lot of things can be applied. Clear? Yes. So try to think, brainstorm answers on these things. It will tell you what you are missing. Then automatically you will try to see those things in the newspapers. And things will be much, much better. But again, adapt Indian jargon, not only the Western jargon, adapt Indian jargon. Indian ethos, values, dharma, nyaya, niti. So they should come as naturally to you as morality, value system and ethics. It shows your answer copy in a whole different light. Yes. So when you read a particular chapter in the syllabus copy, like thinkers, great thinkers and leaders, etc. Some line is there, right? What are the lessons from the great leaders? So that is where you learn all these things, Gandhi, Buddha, so on and so forth. Okay, see you all tomorrow then. Please think about them and see in the newspapers. Okay, right, thank you.